So how should you go through an online video course? Skip ahead, miss sections, play videos at 2x speed? Let's talk about the pros and cons of doing that in today's video. Welcome back, my name is Tim Buchalka with another programming tip of the day. And today we're talking about how you should go about going through an online video course, because there's lots of different ways of doing it. Some people prefer to go through the video from start, the course rather, from start to finish. So they'll watch each and every video in its entirety. They'll go through all the challenges, coding exercises and so on, and get to the end and the finished. Now that's got an obvious advantage of not missing anything. Very importantly, you've gone through everything, you've done all the examples, the coding exercises and challenges, and hopefully you've got a lot out of the course. But for some other people, particularly those people who may have some existing experience in that particular technology that's being taught in the course, perhaps it's a good idea to start skipping some sections. So you might look at, for example, the introductory side of things, the first two or three sections perhaps of a course that goes through the real basic things, and skip those and then go to a particular area. Well, I'm going to suggest in general that's not a good idea. And the reason is, over the years I've found that programmers, even if you have picked up skills in a particular language or framework or whatever it is elsewhere, if you picked up those skills elsewhere, you can find when you go to another course that's taught in a slightly different way, or perhaps there was something that was omitted in that other training that you'll find in the new course. So if you skip ahead and just assume that you know all that already, you're opening yourself up for the possibility of failure. Now, sometimes I go through video courses still, and I like watching them in their entirety. And believe it or not, even after 35 years as a programmer, I will still sometimes find things that go, wow, I didn't know that. Or like, wow, I didn't realize that. So, I'm still learning every day. I would suggest you don't skip ahead. Now, the same applies also at playing videos faster. Now, some people like to put videos at 1.5 times the normal speed or 2x and just sort of fast forward through it, and they're in a rush to finish it. The other thing I really want to point out here is that you shouldn't be treating this as a race. It's not a race to get to the end of the course quickly. The idea of taking the course, the idea of spending your money, is to learn something to hopefully be able to take those skills and to give yourself a job in the future. So if you're instead hell-bent on finishing the course as quickly as possible, chances are pretty high you're going to miss something. So I would suggest you just take your time, allocate a block of time to finish the course, knowing that it's not going to happen overnight. It's not a race. Take your time, go through it all from start to finish. Again, as I pointed out earlier in the video, do all the coding exercises and challenges, etc., and complete the course in its entirety, and you'll end up a better programmer in the long term because you've fully understood, hopefully, the material that's been taught in that course. Alrighty, so I hope that helped. If you've got any questions, feel free to leave a comment and I'll get back to you. If you're ready to look at the next tip, click on up here and you can check that out. If you're interested in coding specific programming videos, click on the link in the bottom left hand corner. Consider subscribing by clicking on the link up here, and I'll see you soon.